Hi guys, welcome to my studio. My name is Sarah and you will be working out with me. Today's actually May 1st here in Hawaii. It's Sunday and May Day is Lei Day. So today we celebrate by giving leis to our friends and family. And a lei is, if you've never seen a lei, it's made of flowers or leaves and it's usually worn around your neck, or it could be around your head, like a head crown. And it represents, symbolizes the aloha spirit. And the word aloha could mean many things: farewell, hello, welcome, joy, happiness. So we're gonna celebrate today on the Microformer, get our day started, and let's get started. So, one black spring, we're gonna start with abs. I'm gonna get my timer on. And you're gonna come to the front facing the back for a reverse wheelbarrow. So knees on the front platform, hands wide on that carriage. Move your butt cheek forward. You're in a diagonal line and start to push that carriage out slow. Two, slow, three, four, back in slow. You're gonna move nice and slow throughout this whole class. Knuckles are down, shoulder blades are back, chest is open. Get that core warmed up. Hinging through the shoulders, neck is nice and long. So your head is always in line with the spine. Try not to drop your chin, right? Good, breathe in, breathe out. Belly button into the spine, lock the belly button there so you can get that core warmed up. You got a high plank hold in five, in four, in three, two, up on your toes and push that carriage all the way out. If you're very tall, you can move your hands to the back of that carriage a little bit more. Hold it right here, mountain climbers, right knee in, left knee in, good. Otherwise, modification is come down to your knees or just hold. You got 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. We have a bear in 4, 3, 2. High plank hold. Exhale, bend at the knees and hips. Drag the carriage back. Knees will stop underneath those hips and then slowly press it back out. Good. Exhale, back in slow. Inhale, elongate. Good. You have a halfway hold in 8, 7, 6, 5. 4, 3, 2, knees underneath those hips, 2 inches up, 2 inches down. Firm grip in those arms. Lift the back of the chest up to the sky so you're not sinking into your shoulders. You got 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, hold it right here. Just go move that carriage. Bear barrel, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Saw the carriage on your knees in 4, in 3, 2, bring it all the way in. Knees on the back platform, or knees on the front platform. Forearms down, drop your hips, shift forward and back. Good. Long spine, chin off that chest. So feeling that core. Arms are working here. 10, 9, 8, 7. You got 6, you're gonna go into a plank in 5. Up on your toes in 4, 3, 2. Up on your toes right here. Plank to pike in 3, 2. You're gonna pike your hips up with your legs straight. Tippy toes, heels high, and then slowly lower down. 2 inches up is plenty. Try to really lift with your abs. Good. Exhale, lift up, inhale, lower. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. You have a plank hold, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold in that plank. Drop your right hip, center. Left hip, center. Right hip, center. Let's go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, hold. Exhale, bend at the knees, round that back slightly, and slowly out. So bear on your forearms, think about a reverse crunch. Low abs right here, lower abdominals. Exhale, then inhale back. You got 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, halfway hold, 5, 4, 3, 2, 2 inches up, 2 inches down, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, bring it in. Meet me at the back, giant reverse wheelbarrow, hands wide on that back platform, drop your hips, shifting forward and back. You've been here before at the front, it's gonna feel a little bit more challenging at the back. Good, belly button into the spine. Core is strong. Good, watch your form, chin off that chest. Triceps are pointing back. You got 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Giant reverse kneeling crunch, forearms down, Knees stay. Starting from a modified plank, chain into your chest, round that back so much the carriage starts to come in. Inhale, extend the knees back a little bit. Drop your hips, but no arching in that back, no in that spine. Exhale, round it up. Inhale, back slow. 2, 3, 4, chin into your chest, round that back. Knees stop underneath those hips. Feel the upper abs. Halfway in 5, 4, 3, 2, halfway in, 1 inch in, 1 inch out. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, drop your hips, round it up. Good, you got 10, 9, we're gonna come up to a high plank in 7, 6, hands on the rails in 5, 4, 3, 2, up on your toes. High plank hold. Going to a bear in 3, 2, exhale, bend at the knees and the hips, drop the carriage in. Now here for a long, giant reverse bear right here. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, halfway in 5, 4, 3, 2, halfway, 2 inches up, 2 inches down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, one more set in 5, 4, 3, 2, slowly out, slowly in. Good. Mind over matter right here. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, super crunch in 5, 4, 3, 2. Oh, all right, butt's gonna be on the back platform. Believe me, I feel it too. Pull the carriage in, heels over those carriage. Sit up nice and tall, chin off that chest. Pull your shoulder blades back. So you wanna imagine your chest open, long spine. As you send the legs out, you're gonna drop your back 45 degrees without rounding, right? So I want you to keep that spine straight as you lower. Exhale, bend at the knees, knees bring up to the chest. Keep that spine nice and long. If you have anything to grab, you can do light touch right here. And if you want that extra challenge, go for it. Grab those dumbbells or you can just hold it. I'm gonna go into a bicep curl. Legs go out, drop that chest. Curl it in, knees come up. Squeeze through those dumbbells. Low abs, upper abs at the same time. You have a hold in 5. Bend those knees in 4, 3, 2. Bend those knees in. Lower your back. 2 inches up, 2 inches down. Legs are frozen. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it right here. Just open those arms to the right side, gaze to the right, obliques right here, look to the ground, bring it back, left side all the way, gaze to the left, exhale up, inhale, keep your back still, keep your legs still, good, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, hold it right here, just the lower part. So your legs only, lower abs. Keep that chin off that chest. 10, 9, 8. Open up those knees if your hips are tight. 5, 4, 3, 2. Oh, let it go. And we're going to come to the front. Shake it out really quick. We're going to add a red spring. So just a red string, heavy springs. We're going to go into runner's lunge. So right foot on that front platform, left toes in this divot. Sit into that right side lunge. Sit into that right sits bone. Hips and shoulders are squared forward. Slowly push it out, slow 2, slow 3, 4. So check your form right here. Left hip wants to drop and your right hip wants to hike. Drop your right hip, lift your left, and bring your left hip forward, right hip back. So everything's squared forward. Check out your right knee. Right knee should be stacked over that right heel. Breathe in, breathe out. And nice and low. Grab a pole, chair, table, and hold on to it. If you keep popping up, try to keep nice and low. Find that tension in the back of that right leg. Your entire foot is through that platform to activate the back of that right leg. You're gonna feel a little bit of quad stretch on the left side. All right, keep going. Out slow 2, slow 3, 4. Back in slow 2, slow 3, 4. Back out. Keep going right here. Get those legs warmed up. shoulders stack over those hips or a slight hinge forward if you're feeling this in your low back. Good. Lots of variations, lots of options here. Listen to my cues. Find what works for you, you know, for today. Good. Breathe in, breathe out. You have a press back in five, in four, in three, two, press it all the way back, 1 inch in, 1 inch out, press it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, hold it halfway in, 2 inches up, 2 inches down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, full range. Press it all the way back first, fight that tension coming back in. The slower you go, the more muscle fibers you are gonna fire up. The more muscles you stimulate, more calories, more fat you burn. You get the point. So go slow, challenge those muscles. Think about the muscles. Good, you have 10, 9, 8. We have a mega donkey kick. You're gonna come down to your left knee on the floor. In 5, 4, 3, 2, bring the carriage in. Left knee's gonna come down to the side of that carriage. Hands on the front part of that platform rail. Right ankle to that corner of that carriage. Push that carriage out. Slowly in, slowly out. Try to keep your shoulders square, more forward. So right here, left knee should be underneath the left hip. You're opening up, the carriage never comes. So the knees are gonna stop just in line with the left. So carriage always open. Constant tension there. So if this is too light for you, move the left knee back a little bit, open up those hips. Good, working the side of that right leg. To stay here. So right here, you have a nice long line in the arms. No bend in that wrist line. Know that you're pushing through the palm of that left hand, but slurp the arms into the shoulder sockets. Feel it in the back muscles. Optional, pick up that left knee, try it out. You're nice and low to the ground. If you fail, you're not very far from the ground, so you're not gonna fall very far. All it is a tap down, right? Okay, try it out here. Nicely done. Press it back in 5, 4, 3, 2, press it back, tiny presses. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, hold it right here, 2 inches up, 2 inches down, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, full range. Keep your spine nice and long, chin off that chest. You're gonna feel this a little bit in your core and your obliques. Nicely done. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Bring it in. We're gonna go to the back. One black spring. So just one light spring here. Hands on the bars. Step your right foot onto the, grab the carriage in. Bring your right foot on the platform. Slight turnout. And slowly lift up. Curtsy express lunge. Grab a pole chair for support. The left heel is high. It's a small turnout, right? So the right foot should not be pointing towards the right side. It's just a little bit of turn toward away from the center, pointing towards your right side. Keep your hips and shoulders still squared. And if this feels impossible, you know, try stepping down towards number four. You can still have a turn. And you're just gonna scooch that left foot a little bit closer towards the right side of that carriage. Good. Are you breathing here? Because I'm finding myself out of breath because I'm talking. Maybe I'm slightly holding my breath. Okay. Nice and slow. Good. You have a hold in 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it down right here. 1 inch up, 1 inch down. 10, 9. Feel the back of that right leg still squeezing up and down. 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it right here. Carriage kicks. Bend that back knee in. Feel the obliques turn on when the exhale pulls in and back out. Bend that right leg a little bit more. Find assistance, find help. 5, 4, Three, two, left knee underneath the left hip, lift up and down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, push it out, full range. Nicely done. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, kneeling in our thighs. 4, 3, 2, bring the carriage all the way in. Put your right knee on the back platform, left knee on the carriage. Grab your dumbbells if you want some arms to go with it. Tricep extensions right here. Open up. Push your butt cheek forward, shoulders stack over those hips. Elbows are pointing forward. If that doesn't work for you, you can go into a rotator's curl. With or without dumbbells, one thing is you should be focusing in your inner thighs. So if the dumbbells are distracting, just lose them. Shoulder sack over those hips. Pull up through your inner thighs, pelvic floor, and abs. So your pelvic floor is parallel to the floor. It's a muscle that holds your organs inside of you. So you gotta really strengthen that. If you don't know where that muscle is, think about the muscles down there that, you know, holds your urine. So when you sneeze and you twinkle, that's that muscle group that holds everything in together. Push your butt cheek forward. Lift and squeeze in and up. Shoulder blades back. Good. Halfway out in 3, 2, out. 1 inch up, 1 inch down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, full range. Nice. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, bring it in. Side plank. So stack your knees on the carriage. You can stagger them or stack. Right forearm's gonna be down. You're still facing towards your left side. Push your butt cheek forward, shoulders stack. Grab your dumbbell if you want to on the left hand. Lift up 1 inch, down 1 inch. Up 1 inch, down 1 inch. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Thread the needle. Lift your right hip. Give yourself a big hug. Nice. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Giant reverse kneeling crunch, right side. Forearm's gonna be down facing the back. Stack or stagger your knees, slowly send it out. You're still feeling that right oblique, chin into your chest, round that back, curve starts to come in. My advanced people, you can lift up the back upper leg. So single leg, side crunch here. Inhale, extend, drop your hips, keep that right hip lifting though. Exhale, round it up, pull it in. Nicely done, guys. Shifting forward, back, forward and back in 5, 4, 3, 2. Shift forward and back. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, come to the front. Add another light spring. So we got two light springs on. If you don't have the cables, grab one or two dumbbells. You're gonna go into a kneeling torso twist, guys. All right, so grab, ooh. So your right oblique should be facing the back platform for right oblique exercise. Otherwise, so start them if you have cables. Everyone else, it's gonna look like this. Center up, turn, and back center. Okay, so I'm gonna be not facing you. Start with the dumbbells or cable in the center of your chest, and you're gonna rotate towards the front. And then back center. Pressing your hips facing forward. So the hips will not turn. You gotta keep that left hip bone shining forward. So both hips are facing forward even though you're doing that torso rotation. So if the weight's too much for you, you can soften in the elbows. Otherwise, try to keep them nice and round. Shoulders are down, chest is open. 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it to the side, lift up and down. 10, 9, 8, 7. We're going back to legs in 6, in 5, in 4, 3, 2. Let it go. Okay, one red spring. One red spring. Standing up, let's go. Runner's lunge in three, you're moving in two. Let's go. Back slow two, slow three. Four back in, slow two, slow three, four. Okay, settle into it right here. Sit into that left sits bone, left knee stacked over that left heel. Hip bones are shining forward, shoulders are facing forward. Right knee, cap pointing down towards the floor. Grab a table, pull a chair, whatever you've got. Try to hold into it as long as you can without taking any breaks. We got 2 minutes on each leg for each exercise. Not very long if you think about it. Most of the time, your mind acts faster than your body, your muscles. Our mind is telling ourselves, okay, you can't do it anymore. Get up, take a quick break. But if you can just kind of push through that, your muscles are much stronger than your mind think they are, to be, believe it or not, right? Good, left knee over that left heel. Really sit into it. Shoulder stack over those hips or a slight hinge forward. Good. Really dig into that left foot, activating the back of that left foot. So you gotta press that big toe, second toe, pinky heel all the way down through the platform to activate the back of that left leg. Press it back in five, in four, in three, two, press it back 1 inch, in 1 inch, out. Can you get nice and low right here? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, halfway in, 2 inches up, 2 inches down. 10, 9, 8, 7, full range, 6, in 5, in 4, in 3, 2, full range. Push it back first and fight that tension coming in slow, 2, slow, 3, 4, back out, slow, 2, slow, 3, 4, back in, good. Keep it up. You got it. In 10, we're moving. In 9, mega donkey kick. Left side in 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Bring it in, shake it out really quick. Or come down to your right knee, just by the side of your right carriage. Hands on the bars on the front platform. Left heel to the edge of the back of that carriage. Push it out. Settle into it. Shift your right knee back if you can. Put your right knee underneath the right hip and push it out slow. 2, slow 3, 4. Back in slow. Same thing here. Elongate that wrist line. Press into that palm, activate the back muscles. No weight in that right hand. Side of that left leg right here, side glutes, outer thighs, outer butt cheek. Core is strong right here, holding the upper body. Fight that tension. If you want to, pick up that right knee. Flying mega donkey kicks right here. Or flying micro donkey kicks, since we're on a micro. You know what I mean. Okay, this feels good. I'm more than halfway, you know, or almost halfway through the leg. Press it out in 5, in 4, 3, 2, press it out, 1 inch in, 1 inch out. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, halfway in, 2 inches up, 2 inches down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, full range. OMG, I'm having a hard time pushing it out. Oh, gotta struggle for that change, guys. It's not easy, and it's never been, I've never told you it's gonna be easy. Good, right here, but you can do it. Remember this, guys. You committed to getting on the microformer today. That is half the battle. Now that you're on it, you just gotta push through it. Of course, don't push through any pain. All right, 10, 9, 8, 7. Meet me at the back for curtsy express lunge. 5, 4, 3, 2. Carriage comes in. Let's go down to one black spring. One light spring here, one black spring. Tuck the right foot into that carriage. Pull the carriage in. So your left foot could be by number 4, slight turnout, or on the carriage, or on the platform. So left toe, just turn, you know, 10 degrees toward the left a little bit. Right toe, just directly back behind that left heel. Starting with 2 straight leg, down slow 2, slow. Three, four, back up, slow, slurp it in and up. Good. Shoulder stack over those hips, hips are square. You can have a tiny hinge forward if you like that. You get a little bit lower, sitting to that left side. Good. Left knee is behind the toe line, right? Over the heel. You have a hold in 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it down, 1 inch up, 1 inch down. Shoulder blades back, right? Try not to hinge or hunch forward. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it right here, carriage kicks. Option to bring your hands down. I know, this is not considered cheating, guys. I'm still working the same muscle groups. Bring it in and out. 10, 9, 8, 7, halfway in 5, in 4, in 3, 2, right knee underneath the right hip, 2 inches up, 2 inches down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, send it out, full range. Okay, there's one thing you have to know for my classes. I don't think I've ever said this, but I really don't believe in, quote, cheating. There's definitely shortcuts, variations, modifications. But you know how your body's gonna feel or how it feels. So you're gonna make that decision for yourself. I'm gonna give you the tools to succeed, to do better, to push yourself. But guess what? I'm not there to do it for you. You are there for yourself. So think about why you're here, why you're doing this to your body. And you know what? The rest just comes. All right, 10, kneeling in our thighs, in 9, in 8, you're gonna come down to your knees in 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, left knee's gonna come down. Oh, let me grab my dumbbells. Bring that carriage in, stack your knees. Push your butt cheek forward, shoulders stack. Send it out, slow 2, 3, 4. Back up, lift it up, slurp it in, center up, and push it out. Send the gravity, center of the gravity with the carriage. So if you want to do the inner thighs correctly, whether it's in the front or at the back, you always want to shift the center of gravity with the carriage as you become better. My beginners, just try to move. Don't overthink it. But as you become more familiar with the moves, you want to try to work equally on both legs, both inner thighs. You'll find that some of the classes, I really like to do inner thighs, so most of the time we'll have two sets. So you'll find it on the right side, on the left side. But for some classes, either you're taking group classes or other instructors, they only do one set. And technically, you're supposed to work both inner thighs during that one set. So, okay. You can go into shoulder raise, lateral raise, bicep curl, something. Or just work on those inner thighs. Shoulder blades back. I'm gonna go rotator's curl right here. Hold it out in 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it out, 1 inch in, 1 inch out. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it out, 2 inches up, 2 inches down on those arms. Wherever you are, go 1 inch up, 1 inch down, or 1 inch out, 1 inch in. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Full range. You got 10, 9, 8. We have that oblique series in 5, in 4. Side plank in 3, 2. Okay, so stack your knees or stagger them. Come down to your left forearm. Push your butt cheek forward, stack shoulder over those shoulders, hips over hip. Right arm up with or without the dumbbells. 1 inch up, 1 inch down. Small range of motion here. Lift out of that left side, right here. So instead of sinking into your left shoulders, I want you to press your forearms up and lift away from the platform. 8, 7, thread the needle. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Give yourself a hug. Turn your shoulders, open up. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Giant reverse kneeling crunch left side. Forearms gonna be on the platform. Same thing with the knees, slowly out. Chin off that chest, elongate that spine. Chin into your chest, round that up, bring it in. Advanced people, you can extend that top leg if you want to. You're working the left side of your abs, which is your left obliques. Nicely done. Weekends always pass by so fast. You won't believe it. So, yesterday, I wanted to do all these active things, but it was pretty rainy out since Friday. So instead, I had all afternoon and evening to myself at home. Took an afternoon nap. I slept early. I probably slept, I don't know, a combination of 10 hours. It felt really good. It's really nice to just, you know, be able to listen to your body and just go with it. Okay, we're gonna move on. In 10, 9, kneeling torso twist. In 7, you're gonna go to the front, 2 black springs. In 5, quick transitions. In 4, in 3, 2, left side should be facing the back. So that means that your left oblique should be facing the back platform. So grab a cable, center up, or the dumbbell. Push your butt, hips forward, and rotate. Bring it center, rotate, keeping your right hip forward as you turn. Same thing here, if it's too heavy, you'll know when it's too heavy. When your shoulders start to go like this, this is exaggerating, but. So you can bend those elbows to bring the weight down a little bit. It might feel different one side from another, or you're just tired because we're almost done. Right hip forward, keep your right hip forward. Try not to open up as you turn. Good. Hold it out in 5, in 4, in 3, 2, rotate. 1 inch up, 1 inch down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Can you smile? In 5, in 4, in 3, 2. Let's go kneeling lat pull down. So same thing here. Still with the 2 light springs. Pull yourself to the back. Hands wide on those bars. If not overhand, you can grab the side of the platform bars right here. Stick out your butt cheek. Extend that spine, so lift the heart up. Your heart should be higher than your butt cheek. Elbows nice and wide, squeeze, and center in. Good. If you don't have the bars at the back, everyone else just stay in it. If you don't have the back bars at the back, go into a chest press with your dumbbells. Try to feel the back muscles, right? Kind of mimic my movements. When you don't have certain parts to the micro, you can always substitute by mimicking the movements with dumbbells. And if you don't know how to do a move, just ask me. I will always respond to your questions. Drop a comment, DM me on Instagram. You know the drill. Halfway in 5, 4, 3, 2, halfway, 1 inch out, 1 inch in. Let's go. Squeeze the mid back muscle as you lift in and out. Feel the middle part of your back muscle squeeze in. Imagine a pencil there holding it together. Good, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, overhand grip on the platform bars in 5, 4, 3, 2, overhand grip. Elbows are pointing down, triceps lat pull down. Extend that spine, stick out your butt cheek. Keep the heart higher than your butt. Squeeze the elbows to the sides of your rib cage. Nicely done. Halfway in 5, in 4, in 3, 2, halfway in, 1 inch out, 1 inch in. Keep that heart lifting up. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, full range in 5, 4, 3, 2, full range of motion. You got it. 10, 9, 8, 7. We're going to go into a sexy back. If you don't have cables, grab those dumbbells. In 4, facing the back platform. In 3, 2, okay, 1 red spring, just 1 heavy. You're gonna stand up, crisscross those cables. Oh, sorry, we're not gonna crisscross. Okay, palms facing back, extend that back, sink into that squat, lift it up. So this is gonna feel heavy, so you're gonna walk forward. Keep that heart lifting up, squeeze the middle part of the back muscle, get nice and low in that squat. Keep the elbows high. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, hold it up, extend that spine, arms along, press it up, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, chest opener, stand up nice and tall, roll the shoulder blades a couple times, lift it up, drop it down, lock it down, open up that heart, chest is open, press it back, so your hands are pointing, reaching down towards the floor, as you extend that spine, press it back. This is a good exercise to reset your posture. A lot of times we're kind of curled, crunched forward in front of our computer, watching TV. So if you want to get nice and tall, you got to do this move more often. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Take one step back. You're going to go into a squat with a bicep curl. Squat back curl. Send it up. Push your butt cheek forward. Good. Hold it down in 5, 4, 3, 2, squat back, hold. We're gonna go into a bicep row. So you might wanna take a step back a little bit more, row it back. Palms up, squeeze through those dumbbells or squeeze through the handlebars. Mid back muscles squeezing as your elbows go back. Pull your abs in. 10, 9, 8. Really think about your back muscles, guys. Yes, they're muscles too. 5, 4, 3, 2, halfway back, 1 inch back, 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 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Row it out right here. Working that back muscle here. Can you take another step back? Stick out your butt cheek. So think about your mid-back muscle squeezing in as the elbows reach back. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it halfway. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Stand up. Walk forward, one last set of chest opener. Lift the heart up, drop the shoulder blades. Good. Extend those arms, feel those triceps. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. We got a reverse catfish. If you don't have those high bars, you're gonna bring your hands to the floor or those platform bars. In 3, 2, 1, black spring. Switch it up really quick. Final ab move right here. Hands on the high bar, toes underneath the straps. Bring the carriage in and out. Tippy toes, back lifting up, butt cheeks behind the shoulders, knuckles down. Press into the bar as you lift the chest away. Low abs right here. Slowly in, slow 2, 3, 4, back out, slow 2, 3, 4, back out, in, back out. Nicely done. Keep breathing, guys, you got it. You can see the end of the tunnel. It's right there. Bring your focus back to those muscles. Bring your focus back to this right now. You got 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold in that plank. Mini or full push-up, chest and back work right here. Good, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Plank to pike on the high bars or on the low bars. Low bars are gonna be harder. In 5, 4, 3, 2, plank to pike right here. If you wanna come down to low bars, go ahead. Exhale, lift up, inhale lower. Keep those tippy toes high. Last move right here, last 10. Last 9, last 8, 7, child's pose in 6, final 5, final 4, 3, 2, child's pose, knees down. Extend, sink into your butt cheek. Round it up, stretch it out, and bring it back. Come on up, standing up, lift your hips up. Bend that leg one at a time. Push the carriage down, forward for that downward facing dog. And then roll your vertebrae up one vertebrae at a time. Roll the shoulder blades back. Take a deep inhale, reach up to the sky. Open up that heart, bend those elbows. One more time. And guess what? You get to start the rest of your day nice and strong and feeling good. Thank you so much for showing up. Thank yourself for showing up, and please like, subscribe, share my workout, and I'll see you guys next time. Have a great day.